Welcome friends. Ngandong Tiger versus Smilodon Populator. Who would win between these two deadliest giant big cats? They both considered to be extinct now. The Ngandong Tiger Panthera tigris soloensis, was also known as Pleistocene Tiger, was an extinct subspecies of modern tiger found in Sundaland region of Indonesia in the Pleistocene epoch. The few fossils of Ngandong Tiger suggest that it was larger than any modern tiger. The Ngandong Tiger was one of the largest subspecies of tiger ever. The reason for its large size was due to the presence of larger competitors and large prey animals, which were found in abundance. The Smilodon, often called a saber-toothed cat, or wrongly a saber-toothed tiger, was an extinct genus of machairodonts. This saber-toothed cat was endemic to South America, living from near the beginning through the very end of the Pleistocene epoch. Smilodon Populator occurred in the eastern parts of South America about 1 million to 10,000 years ago and was the largest species of all machairodonts. It was much larger than its cousin Smilodon fatalis and Smilodon gracilis, possessing a massive chest and front legs, and is the largest known variety of saber-toothed cat. Now let's find out who would win if they face a fight. Size and weight. The Ngandong Tiger was measuring up to 8.5 feet from head to tail. It could have measured in excess of 4 feet long at the shoulder, and the maximum weight recorded up to more than 480 kg. On the other side, Sabertooth is estimated around 8 feet from head to tail and approx 3.9 feet tall at the shoulder. The average weight of Smilodon was ranging between 220 to 436 kg, but the maximum weight recorded up to 500 kilograms. Habitat and epoch. This tiger inhabited the Sundaland region of Indonesia during the Pleistocene epoch. The Ngandong Tiger was found in the central Java province of Indonesia, the Solo region. The Ngandong Tiger circled the earth in the late Pleistocene epoch about 1,95,000 years ago. Smilodon probably lived in closed habitats such as deep forest and bush of South America, which would have provided cover for ambushing prey. Smilodon died out at the same time that most North and South American megafauna disappeared, about 10,000 years ago, throughout the Pleistocene till the very early of Holocene. Speed. The average speed of Ngandong Tiger is approx 25 miles per hour. But I am not 100% sure about speed. Oppositely, Smilodon was not a very fast runner and could not be adapted for chasing after fast running prey like deer. It could reach speed up to 27 miles per hour. Bite force. There is no exact bite force of Ngandong Tiger, but it could be estimated around 1,350 pounds per square inch, comparing the size with the Siberian tiger. Surprisingly, Smilodon bite was weaker than modern-day lions, but it didn't need a powerful bite to drive its two razor-sharp fangs home. After research, scientists revealed that Smilodon tooth was so much large, but it was not so much strong. Is always broken. That means the bite force of Smilodon was very weak, around 270 to 330 pounds per square inch. Weapons. Both big cats had more or less 7.5 to 10 centimeter long claws, but the canines of Smilodon was so much large, measuring about 12 inch long. While the Ngandong tiger had only 5.25 inches long canines. Agility. According to research, the skeleton of Ngandong tiger shows that it was more agile, stronger, and faster than that of the saber-toothed cat. Competitors and prey. A question always arises in mind that why was the Ngandong tiger and saber-tooth so huge? One possible answer to this is the abundance of prey and its competitors. The prey of Ngandong tiger including bovid, young elephant, rhinos, etc. It required much power to destroy such a huge prey, for which these felines had to be so huge. The main competitors of Ngandong tigers is maybe giant hyena. Oppositely, Smilodon hunts some slower animals such as ground sloth, mammoth, and sleeping macrochenia at night. An isotopic study suggests macrochenia was Smilodon populator's favorite prey, and they was compete with the 3-meter tall terror bars of South America. Fight. Now let's see who would win this bloody battle. If two cats are released from the time machine and into the arena, at first they pay each other little attention, but soon the pangs of hunger begin to close in. Both cats rush each other and begin to battle. A deadliest paw-swipes and bites erupt, but neither cat can gain the advantage. In the end, both cats mortally wound each other and drop to the ground to die. These both big cats are belong to more or less equal habitat, that is temperate tropical forest. So I think environment wouldn't be the great advantage of both of them. This fight will be incredibly close. The saber-toothed is slightly heavier and has better acceleration. Its bite once administered will cause death more quickly. It's more powerful and better able to hold down a victim. But the tiger is faster with far more powerful jaws, strong bite force, more agile, and probably better in a grapple, as it can grab and hold with its jaws. Of course, Smilodon could kill the Ngandong tiger if it could get its saber teeth into the tiger's flesh, which still could happen if Smilodon ambush and attacked fast. But the characteristics of Smilodon really only help it with hunting. While in a fight against a predator like the tiger, Smilodon has most of the disadvantages in that case. The Ngandong tiger and saber-toothed tiger both are contenders for the largest cat that ever lived. The Smilodon canines might not be good for fighting, but they are very sharp and an effective weapon for killing large animals quickly, so they shouldn't be underestimated. These both cats have enough strength and power that can kill each other. The Ngandong tiger is taller, but Smilodon weighs more. The saber-tooth has two deadly swords, but the tiger has a better bite. If you are going to make me choose, I will give 5 star to Ngandong tiger and give 4 star to Smilodon, since its bite has a better chance of killing the opponent. So at last, it has been concluded that the outcome of a fight are totally depends on the individual situations, their fighting style and size. I mean, if this battle happen with same size individual, then it will must goes to the favor of Ngandong tiger. And if this battle happen with large size Smilodon and small tiger, then it will must goes to the favor of Smilodon populator. So in my opinion, they both have 50-50 chances to win or lose this battle. Thanks for watching and don't forget to like and share.